In the last episode, we talked about a scalar, vector, and matrix. In this episode and the following one, we will go deeper and investigate different aspects of vectors. Let's start by reviewing what we learned about vectors. We saw that vectors are lists of numbers with a specific lengths and directions. It's absolutely correct, but there is more. It's a simplified version of what we have in linear algebra. Elements in a vector usually are numbers, but it's good to know that we can use functions inside a vector or use complex numbers. However, the type of elements doesn't matter. Vectors are a storage of listed elements, which most of the time are numbers. They have an important characteristic, the dimension. It's super important, and we will see why dimension in linear algebra is like a key to operate more advanced operations. But what do we know about dimensions so far? We know that in vectors, dimensions represent the number of elements inside a vector, which shows the number of axes we have in our coordinate system. As we discussed before, dimension is indicated using R, and we show the number of dimensions alongside the letter R. But what have we learned about vectors in geometric space? Let's start from a point in the coordinate system. We can easily locate a point in the coordinate system by calculating its distance from the origin along each axis. For example, in a 2D coordinate system, we need the coordinates of the point along the x-axis and the y-axis. Like this point, which has the coordinates of 1 and 1. This point just gives us information about its location, but nothing more. Now we want to move this point to another location, such as minus 2 and 2. We can represent this movement using a vector in this geometric space. This vector starts from 1 and 1 and ends at minus 2 and 2. But there is an interesting point about vectors, and that is the location of a start and end of vector has no matter. What's important to us is how much and in which direction vector moves. This means we can analyze the vector relative to my axis in the coordinate system. For instance, starting from the point 1 and 1, we can determine how far we need to move along each axis to reach the point minus 2 and 2. As you can see, to reach the second point, we need to move backward 3 units along the x-axis and move forward 1 unit along the y-axis. Since the starting and ending points of a vector are not significant, we will represent our vectors from a common point, the origin of our coordinate system. We can represent vectors with their ending points or head of the vector. It's convenient to show vectors using the location of their heads, because all of our vectors' tails are located at the origin. All right. It's a good time to move forward and understand the concept of transpose in vectors. It's one of the most basic operations and very useful one, which we'll use a lot alongside our more complex operations in linear algebra. Transpose can operate on vectors and matrices, but here we want to study transpose in vectors. And in the future, we will study it in matrices. As we know, vectors can have either one row or one column. depending on their orientation. In the realm of linear algebra, the choice between representing a vector as a row vector or a column vector typically doesn't make a fundamental difference. This is because the essence of the vector is their components, and its properties remain the same regardless of how it's represented. But what does transpose mean in vectors? Consider a 3D and 4D vector like this. The transpose of a vector converts column vector into row vector, and vice versa, row vector into column vector. It's important to consider, transpose never changes the order of components. The order of elements or components remain the same as previously, and just change the orientation of them. We show transpose in linear algebra using the letter T above the vector name. For example, if I have a vector named P, we show P transpose like this. But a simple question arises. What happens if I calculate the transpose of a vector 2 times? As you guess, if I transpose the transpose of my vector, it simply becomes back to what it was before. But why transpose matter at all? Didn't we say before that there is no difference between row orientation and column orientation in vectors? As we said before, in pure math, if components of two vectors are the same, those vectors are considered equal. However, in linear algebra, we need to adhere to certain rules in some operations. The choice of representation of vectors can matter in a specific context like matrix operation, transformations, and inner product. And that's why transpose is so important. We will discuss more about it when we need to actually perform these kind of operations. But right now, we just need to understand what transpose means in vectors.